Super Mario Brothers. Whee-hee!
Hey everybody, welcome back to New Super Mario Bros. Wii. Last time we started with World 6, and in this video we're going to finish up World 6. We have a few levels here. The first one is that level up there, but let's go over here first and get some items. Don't really need any, but, you know, it's already here, so we'll see what we can get. Okay. I remember, I think, was it the last one I did? I actually got pretty far before I found, the bad stuff. Ooh. Let's go with this one. Okay. Wow, okay. If I can get that penguin suit, I'll be happy. Oh, shoot. let's try this one. Nice! This one? I got that. Oh, this is really close. So, one of these is a Bowser, two of these are a Bowser Jr., and one is the propeller mushroom. What? I'm in shock. Wow. That's like the second time that's ever happened to me. Well, second or third. I don't know. Anyway, we got a bunch of items, so that's cool. Next up is World 6-5. Wait, what? Hang on. Oh, great. You know, I was expecting... Okay, I thought the next level was going to be 6-6. Well, not like the layout. I was expecting to see the underwater cave. Okay, but this one, it's interesting. There's like a rising tide. Nothing's happened with the water yet. But the Porky Puffer is here, and he is incredibly annoying. There we go, there's the tide. Okay, I do recommend waiting for the Porky Puffer to come by before you go for that star coin. Actually, I might even wait for him here. Okay, never mind. But yeah, the Porky Puffer was first in Super Mario World. Pretty much did the same thing. Tried to, like, chase you around to run into you. There was a fish in Super Mario Bros. 3 that kind of did the same thing, except instead of running into you, would actually try to eat you. So, I think that one was scarier. Okay, there is a hidden exit here, too. Hopefully I can remember where it is, because, you know, I played this, man, a little after the last recording, which is... Oh man, it's been a month ago already. But, oh, you know what? It's here. This one's actually kind of tough to find, really. I'm gonna put this down and knock him out. Oof. There we go. Oh, shoot. There it is. Okay. That one can be really tough to find. Okay, let's climb up here, and we have the secret area. Take this just in case. Wait, this is the hidden exit? Well, the third star coin is here. Oh, it is the hidden exit, okay. I couldn't remember if it was just the star coin, but yep, this is a hidden exit. We're gonna go here, and then come back to this level, and go through the regular exit. You know, it's so nice that I got that mushroom house, because last time I had such... I didn't have a very good run last time, so... That's cool. Okay, as you can see, that leads up to the castle, but we're not going to go there yet. We'll go through the regular exit first. As you saw, there is a cannon on the left side of the map. That is actually a hidden exit, or you get there through a hidden exit that's in World 6-6. So we're going to have to find another hidden exit in the next level. Well, since I have all the star coins, I'm going to... Oh, great. I was going to say I'm going to rush through, but, you know, maybe that's not a good idea. Yeah. Okay, there is a flower here. Okay, yeah, so I lucked out. Actually lost all that stuff at a decent spot in the level. I can recover quickly. Or I did recover quickly. But yeah, like I said in... Oh, shoot. Okay, he's not here. Well, he's here now, but like I said, I think in the last video, or one of the ones before that, we're getting close to the end now. I mean, not quite, but we're over the halfway point at least, and we have just this video left for World 6, and World 7, 2 videos, World 8, probably 3 videos, and then World 9, 2 videos. And then we're done. Now, it's taken me a little while to get through this. I mean, this was never like... Well... Maybe at first it was, but after maybe the first few episodes, it was just something I was going to go back to when I had free time. There's been so many games that came out since I started this. I started this, like, the end of December of last year. Oh, good, he doesn't show up here. but yeah, we'll get through this. I'm aiming for the end of the summer, so I have, like, another month left, so... Hopefully I can get through this before then. If not, then... Oh well. But yeah, a lot of things have changed in the last several months, actually, since I started this playthrough. I did move. I don't know if I mentioned that earlier. Just last week I got a new roommate, so... You know, I've recorded while my roommate's here, but it's kind of weird. I mean, they know I, you know, record stuff on YouTube and stuff like that, but it's kind of awkward, I guess. Okay, but this one, you can control the light here with the Wii Remote. You just tilt it left and right, however you want. Oh, I'm gonna grab this spring. Because I'm probably gonna need that later. Yeah, you can even control it when you're not on the raft. Okay, I don't want to grab that yet. See, I don't want to mess this up because the star coin's right here. Oh, shoot. Okay, I didn't mean to fall, but that ended up working out anyway. So it does help to have the fire flower here, obviously, because there's a lot of piranha plants. Let's watch out. Ooh, that's gonna be nice. See, I like when you get the Starman in these dark levels because it illuminates the whole area. It's awesome. But yeah, as I revealed a few weeks ago in my ukulele demo video, my next single player playthrough, is going to be Banjo-Kazooie, so I'm really looking forward to that. I actually haven't recorded that. It's been a little while. I recorded like the first few episodes and then I haven't played it since then. I just haven't had time. So, yeah, that's going to be next. Another spring. Whoa! Okay, that was close. Okay, I'm going to try to stay on this top side because I feel like the second star coin... Yeah, it's right here. Okay, just watch out for the swoopers. They actually look pretty cool in the dark. You just see their eyes. Okay. Oh, no! Oh, I didn't want to jump on that. Okay, the third star coin... Oh, I missed that. I'm gonna grab this. Yeah, it's right here. Okay, I wasn't safe from that. Oh! Okay, but yeah, you can get to that top part as Super Mario or anything above that. It looks kind of small, but you can actually get up there. And I don't want to get hit by this guy. Oh! Oh. Okay, I didn't mean the wall jump. But I ended up in that pipe with that, so... Okay, we're gonna show the hidden exit here. Oh no! Oh. Okay, I kind of panicked and just started running, but they kind of caught up to me. Okay, well, we're gonna go back again. Okay, this time I'm gonna use a fire flower. That's what I should have done in the last run, but I totally forgot about it, so... This should help out, and I can get rid of those swoopers, because they're really annoying. Wait, what did I kill? I don't think that was a swooper. It was probably a cheap sheep. Like I mentioned earlier, I'm going to work on Banjo-Kazooie, and then, you know, I don't really have any... I mean, I want to start another Mario one, but it's probably not going to happen anytime soon. Banjo-Kazooie is going to take a little while. I mean, it's not that long of a game, but it just... It's going to require a lot of time to, you know, record the playthrough and everything, edit it, all that fun stuff. And plus, I'm already uploading a multiplayer game, so that's taking up a lot of time, too. I think I mentioned this earlier in the playthrough. Hard to remember because, you know, I started this in December. But, I think I mentioned it. But, the next one is going to be Super Mario Bros. 3. Want to start that over again. Okay, these are the guys that got me last time. Ah, see, he had his arm up to throw the fireball, but I didn't throw it in time. Well, I should be okay without a fire flower, but, yeah, it would have been nice to have one. There we go. Yeah, I wonder if I can get one here. Oh, shoot. Oh, it is one. Okay, I'm gonna go... Ooh. I'm gonna go up to the hidden exit. And with this, this should help me out. Because I could shoot down all these swoopers. The only thing is, I don't have to use this, but it's really helpful. I think I could throw this at them too. Yeah, you can. Yeah, this is much better. Yeah, sometimes rushing through some of these parts in the levels, it works. Other times it doesn't. Okay, I think that's the rest of them. Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah, I know. We're at the end. Well, at the end where the hidden exit is. I do have to go through this level again with the regular exit. What? Oh, okay. You know, I might try to get this... Because I did lose two lives in there. Okay, and like I mentioned before, this will take us to the canon, World 6 canon, which I think takes us to World 8, just like the World 5 one. I mean, I would think it's World 8, because... I don't think it's just gonna warp us to the next world. We're almost already at World 7 anyway. But we're gonna find out. Oh, you know what? I didn't know there was solid ground down there. I thought it was somewhere you could actually die. So yeah, it does take you to World 8. I guess these warps are nice if you're speedrunning, but for me personally, I don't think I'd use these just because I like to go through all the levels. But yeah, if you're just trying to get to the end as fast as possible, yeah, these are excellent to use. Let's go this way. I didn't go to that one-up house, but yeah, we're just gonna skip that for now. I don't remember if I have to go to that, but I don't think so. I don't think for the one-up houses you have to, they're not required for 100% completion. Oh, I forgot to use a fire flower again. I think we might get some kind of power-up here at the beginning, hopefully. Yeah, perfect. And I did notice in that last run, you do get an ice flower here too, if you want to use it. Jeez, that the trouble getting that over here. That's another one. Oh. Yeah, that's another thing you can do. You can use the power block on the piranha plants here. Which actually is a good idea. Especially if you don't have a fire flower or anything like that. And this also helps too. I just jumped in the water just to get those two. So yeah, we're back at 99. Okay, yeah. We're going into swooper territory again. Trying to attract them so that they fly at the higher heights. Okay, well, we just have to take this slow ride to the end. You know, I tried to get up there, but I guess I can't. I don't know if I need that. I'll just bring it just in case. Now this part right here. Yeah, I always get hit by that one right there. Okay, I'm gonna take this. I'm pretty sure I could. Yeah, I could use it on him. Oh, it's like blew up right in front of him. Whoa! Ah, man. Okay, I'm just not gonna fight them. Although this might be a problem for this part. Oh, no. Okay, that block is literally saving my life. Okay, so that's not that far from the hidden exit. Yeah, that's actually a bigger platform than the hidden exit one. Okay, well, we're finally done with that level. Going through to the hidden exit's kind of crazy because of those fire bros. So yeah, this video's, well, okay. I'll just say it now. There is a fourth level that's going to be in this video. Let's use one of these. I mean, I've already shown this bullet bill thing, so I don't have to fight them. I will go here, though. There we go. It's another star for our collection. I don't know how many we have. Let's check. I wasn't really paying attention to the stars when I did look. 7. Oof, aw, man. That was close, but... yeah, you have to avoid 2 rows of bullet bills there. You know, if I wanted to get through this faster and, you know, in a safer way too, I would have used one of those 7 stars. There we go. Now, I can't remember if... okay, never mind. I wasn't sure if the mushrooms capped out at like 30 or something, but they don't. Anyway, here is World 6 Castle. Like I said, there is another level after this one. But after that, we'll be done with World 6. Okay. Thankfully, they did give us an ice flower. That's going to help out with these, lava bubbles. And the dry bones. There's actually a lot of dry bones towards the end, too. Wait, is it dry bones? There's a few of them in this level, at least. Okay, I remember that part, because that part's really fun. If you don't have the ice flower, you can still get that without it, obviously. It's just a lot easier, and it's a little bit more fun to get it that way. Oh, shoot. Okay, I want this spike ball to fall in lava. Oh, no! Great. Okay, I'm just gonna use the super mushroom because you get the ice flower pretty early on. But yeah, I didn't want to wall jump off that question block. That kind of messed me up. Was not expecting to do that there. There we go. Okay, and that's the next dry bones that we're gonna freeze. Oh, I don't even have to use a super mushroom. Well, just in case, I'll remember that next time. I mean, I have a lot of them, so it doesn't really matter that much. Ooh, I almost fell off there. Alright, you got my extra life back. Okay, there's 2 more. Oh man, I keep slipping off of that part. I mean, the boxes are tilted. Okay, this needs to go. There we go. Ah, man. There we go. Okay, yeah, what a relief that was. Okay. So we just need to get Star Coin 3 and then beat the boss. I'm trying to get this so... okay. So I can cross that safely. This part here... this is gonna be really scary. So not only do you need to watch what's going on down here, you need to watch what's going on up there. And I'm trying to do both. Oh, no, no, no. Oh. Oh, man. Yeah, I might try to use another mushroom there. Okay, but yeah, that part part's crazy. Just because of all that stuff that's going on at once. Okay, thankfully I don't have to deal with Starcoin 2 anymore. Now that I went through the flag there. Yeah, you do get one. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Okay. See, you can kind of time it. If you notice those blocks on the top, they light up as they're about to drop. And it happens, like, in the same increment of time, too. Ooh, that was close. Yeah, I'm just gonna wait. Okay. Yeah, I wasn't sure if I had to freeze that thing or whatever, but yeah, you can actually get that without freezing anything. What's this? Yeah, I'm gonna take this for the boss. It's a lot more useful. Alright, let's go. Okay, we have Morton to deal with here, and as you can see, he ground pounds the ground here, and then those pillars rise. So, if you're standing on one of those and it goes up to the ceiling, you're pretty much automatically dead. It's always the ones that are in front or behind where he lands. Then he always jumps three times. Okay, yeah, and you can surprise him there too. As the pillars are descending, you can actually jump on them really quick. He actually almost got me there. I hesitated a little before I actually made the jump, but he's not too bad. You just have to look out for those things that I mentioned, and yeah, he's not too bad overall. Yeah, well, like I said, there is a fourth level in this part, and it is another airship. But as you can see, there's a path of clouds, so that kind of gives a hint as to what the next world is going to be like. But for now, let's go to World 6 Airship. Or Anchor, but it's an airship. Okay, I think we've seen the Mecha Koopas. Oh, well, you know what? This works out because I'd rather have this. But yeah, I think we've seen them in an earlier level here. Actually, I think it was another airship. But they're back along with the Rocky Wrenches. Oh, man. I thought I could jump over that, but in hindsight, nah, there's no way. Okay, yeah, the Rocky Wrenches, they were on the airships in Super Mario Bros. 3 as well. Yeah, they're kind of a precursor to the Monty Moles. They look like Monty Moles now, but Monty Moles didn't show up until, like, the actual Monty Moles didn't show up until Super Mario World. So, yeah, they were kind of a precursor. I mean, they did look like moles, I guess. It's a little hard to tell, because it was the NES, so. But yeah, and starting with this game, I think they started to look a lot like Monty Moles, but, you know, with things on their heads. Alright, so this is, like, under the ship, and this will lead us to the second star coin. Okay, this part can be a little scary. There we go. There's nothing else here. I don't think there is, so we're just gonna go back up, and here's the halfway point. I might actually go for this. I would like a power-up, and that wrench is flying forever. Ooh. Oh, man, that was close. Man. I didn't see him there. Oh, there's a star coin. Okay. You actually have plenty of time to get that. I mean, you do have to ground pound and a couple boxes there, but the level's not moving that quickly. Probably the most nightmare-inducing level in Super Mario Bros. 3. There's an airship level, but it's made up of like a bunch of little airships. I'm sure those that have played Super Mario Bros. 3 probably know what I'm talking about in World 8. But the screen is moving so fast, and those airships, they're so tiny. Some of them are really tiny. But that level's really difficult. is there another power-up here? That's not the one I wanted, but... Oh well. Okay, this is gonna be fun. So, yeah, you have to spin the clown car here, push Bowser Jr. into the electric fence. This is actually pretty fun. You can spin up too if you want. Are we spinning back? Ooh. There we go. Yeah, I came really close to hitting the fence at one point there. But yeah, if you notice his Hooba clown car is really beat up, you'll see that one again later on. Okay, but now we're completely done with World 6, and we've made it to World 7, and the music here is really good. I like the world theme here. Anyway, in the next video, we're going to get started with World 7-1. We're going to go through probably... Oh, oops. There we go. We're going to go through these levels here up to the fortress. Actually, aren't there two fortresses here? Oh no, I must be thinking of something else. But yeah, we'll go up to the fortress, and then in the next video we'll cover every level up to the castle. Then we can start with World 8 after that. Alright everybody, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.